Well, initially it was because Ron Howard was directing it. It was kind of a no-brainer. If he gave me a script that was toilet paper, I'd say, absolutely, I'm in. But I think there's something about the story of the Essex and the story of Moby Dick that there's a reason that people keep coming back to this story about obsession and how we need each other to survive. And I think there aren't a lot of movies about that these days. And it's a movie I'd like to watch, so to be in it was a pleasure. Well, as grueling as any day could be, because we're hungry and we're out on the ocean for crazy hours and seasickness and weather and the sun and there's something about his energy that just completely wakes you up and makes you want to do the best that you can. And he really is everything they say. Well, I guess the challenge is, what can I learn? You know, how can I do the best I can and also get better? Which is another reason that it's great to work with someone like Ron. Because the day you start shooting, you're going to be better the day you stop shooting. And it was like going to acting school all over again. I have. I think part of its beauty is that it gets a bit tedious in the middle. You know, there's a whole chapter about the pews in a church, and there's something almost trance-like about it. It's not from a time that needs to be the fast story, the episodic. It is a meditation on the human experience, and I think that's important and something that we're losing. As newspapers go to the internet, as we want our news in, you know, streams and little sound bites, there's something about being forced to stop and really reflect on something, like the movie makes you do, how badly we need each other. Well, because there wasn't actually a whale. Yeah, believe it or not, couldn't wrangle a big mutant white whale. That was the first thing that kind of took me aback. You know, you imagine it in your mind, and you spend so much time creating it for yourself that when you see it in all of its majesty, you're kind of flabbergasted by it. And also, Anthony Dodd Mantle's work in it is astounding, because I don't think we shot with less than 4 cameras on a day. You know, he'd put some little camera in your oar, or you're hanging from the sail, and you're like, I don't know what he's doing with that. And then when you see it, you go, oh, that's what he was doing with that. It lends itself to a visual vocabulary that you just can't anticipate on the day. Nobody had it with me.